Hey guys, I am Venkat and this is part 12 of Web Development with Blazor video series. If your application deals with huge volumes of data, performing operations like sorting and paging on the client side is not a recommended approach. Trying to load the entire dataset onto the client machine in one go may explode both the browser memory and rendering engine. So the recommended approach is to perform sorting and paging on the database server. This is the approach that we typically use in real-world web applications, especially if the applications deal with huge volumes of data. In this video, let's discuss implementing both sorting and paging on the database server. Our first step is to modify the server-side REST API to provide sorted and page data. For the REST API to be able to do that, we need to provide it with three things: the number of rows to skip, the number of rows to take, and the columns by which we want the data to be sorted. The REST API will then forward those three parameters to Entity Framework Core. Entity Framework Core will then forward them to the database engine. The database engine will then perform these two operations, sorting and paging, and then return the sorted and paged data to the REST API. The REST API will then return that to the datagrid, which will then display the data as expected. Our server-side API already supports paging. Notice in the URL, we are passing two query string parameters, skip and take. We want to skip 10 rows and take the next 20 rows. And look at the data that is returned by our API. It returned 20 rows, starting with employee ID 11 to employee ID 30. We discussed implementing server-side paging in part 10 of this video series. I'll include the link to the complete course page in the description box below this video. Take a look at our API URL. It is api/employees. So it's the employees controller that provides this employee data. And if we take a look at our employees controller, getEmployees method is right here. Notice it is already taking in these two parameters, skip and take. In addition to these two parameters, we want a third parameter. This is going to be of type string, and let's call it order by. Notice next to the order by parameter, we have a little red squiggly. And when I hover the mouse over, it says optional parameters must appear after all the required parameters. These two parameters, skip and take, are optional. Why are they optional? Well, that's because we have specified the default values. Similarly, we also want to make this order by parameter optional, just in case if the end user did not sort the data in the grid by any specific column, we want the data to be sorted by employee ID column. So let's specify a default value of employee ID. If you want, you can also include sort direction, ascending or descending. If you don't explicitly specify the sort direction by default, the data will be sorted anyway in ascending order. So you may or may not include the sort direction. To keep it simple, I'm going to actually remove it. Now, it is this getEmployees method of employee repository that actually retrieves employee data from the database. So even on this getEmployees method of our employee repository, we need to include this order by parameter. So I have both the employee repository class and the interface files open. If you're wondering where these files are present, well, they are present in the models folder in blazorproject.server. So first, on the getEmployees method within the interface, let's include the third parameter, string order by. Let's do the same thing even in this employee repository class. So if we scroll down a bit, our getEmployees method is right here. In addition to skip and take, we want the third parameter, string order by. And the default value is employee ID column. Notice this employees property on this appdb context instance is of type dbset of employee. Just like how it is supporting these two link methods, skip and take, it also supports order by. And to this order by method, we pass this incoming order by parameter. We have a red squiggly under order by, and that's because we cannot pass a string parameter to order by. For example, if we want the data to be sorted by employee ID column, we have to specify a lambda here. Something like employee goes to employee dot, and then we specify the property by which we want the data to be sorted. But this is not what we want. We want to be able to pass this incoming string parameter, because it is going to contain the comma separated list of columns by which we want the data to be sorted. If this is not clear at the moment, don't worry, it will be in just a bit. So to be able to pass string parameters to these link methods like order by and where, we are going to use something called dynamic link. The website address is dynamic-link.net. So click on Getting Started, Documentation, Basic Usage, Simple Querying. And then if we scroll all the way to the bottom, notice here we are passing a string parameter to the order by link method. And this string parameter contains the list of columns by which we want the data to be sorted. We want to download and install dynamic link NuGet package. Notice on the top right hand corner, we have this download link. Click on that. And then we want to download the NuGet package. So click on NuGet download. It is the command that we want to use to install this dynamic link package. So let me copy that. In Visual Studio, go to Package Manager console. Make sure Blazor Server Project is selected here. And then let's paste the command that we just copied and execute it. Notice we still have a red squiggly under order by, and that's because we are missing a namespace. So using system.link.dynamic.core, and then if we scroll down, notice we no longer have that error on order by. Next, in our employees controller, let's pass this incoming order by parameter to get employees method on employee repository. We're already passing skip and take, so let's also do the same with order by. With all these changes in place, let's run the project and test our API. There we go. We see our application homepage as expected. Before we navigate to our API URL and test, let's go to the output window in Visual Studio, and then from the drop-down list here, select web server, and let's clear everything that's already logged here. And then in the browser, let's navigate to our API URL, api/employees. We want to skip 10 rows and take 20 rows. And we want to sort the data by employee ID column. So let's use order by equals employee ID descending. Now, one important point to keep in mind here is don't include double quotes around order by query string parameter value. If you include double quotes, it doesn't work. Notice the data in the result set is sorted by employee ID column in descending order. In the database, we have a total of 34 rows. So employee data is sorted by employee ID column. It skipped the first 10 rows and then took the next 20 rows. That's why we have rows from 24 to 5. And if we take a look at the query that is issued to the database, here is our select query. Select all the columns from employees table order by employee ID column in descending order. And then we have the parameter values for skip and take, P0 and P1. P0 is 10 and P1 is 20. Our data grid that displays the data is present in this razor file, index.razor. At the moment, only paging is enabled. Let's also enable sorting. And for that, all we need to do is set this property, allow sorting equals true. To provide data to this grid, we are using a custom adapter, employee adapter. And this employee adapter is present in the services folder in our client project. So let's open this file. Notice we are injecting our client-side service, iEmployee service, into the employee adapter. And on this service, we have getEmployees method. It is this method that calls our server-side REST API. Both the service interface, iEmployee service, and the implementation class are present in the services folder in our client project. And I have these two files already open here. Here is the interface. So on this getEmployees method, in addition to skip and take, let's include order by parameter. And let's do the same thing even in the employee service class. We have our getEmployees method here. In addition to skip and take, we want order by. Notice our REST API URL here, we are passing these two incoming parameters, skip and take, as query string parameters. We want to do the same thing with order by as well. Let me actually bring this method call to the next line so we can see the entire code without having to scroll to the right. So in addition to skip and take, we also want to pass order by. The value for it is the incoming order by parameter. Next, in index.razorPage, in addition to enabling sorting, let's also specify some sort settings. For that, we use grid sort settings component. We don't want to allow unsort, so let's set allow unsort equals false. When the data grid first loads, we want the data to be sorted by employee ID column in ascending order. For that, let's include grid sort columns. Inside this, we include grid sort column and then specify the field. We want to sort by employee ID column, so let's specify employee ID. Finally, in employee adapter class, where we are calling getEmployees method, in addition to passing skip and take parameter values, we also have to pass value for order by parameter. So for that, let's create a new variable here. Let's call it order by string and initialize it with null. On this incoming parameter, data manager request, just like how we have skip and take properties, we also have sorted property. So first let's check if sorted property is not null. Notice this sorted property returns a list of sort objects. So I'm creating a variable here of type list of sort and storing that list in this variable. And then each sort object contains these two properties, name and direction. For example, on the UI in the data grid, if I click on employee ID column to sort the data by employee ID column in ascending order, name property will contain employee ID and direction will contain ascending or descending. So here we are building our order by string dynamically. So what we want to be able to do is build a string that looks like this. Remember, the data grid supports multi-column sorting. So here we are sorting by employee ID column first in descending order and then by first name column in ascending order. So between the name of the column and direction, there has to be a space, and then between each column, we need a comma. And that's what we are doing with this line of code right here. So we are selecting name and direction with a space between both of them, and then each column must be separated by a comma. And to get comma, we are using the string join method. All that is left is pass this order by string to get employees method. So in addition to skip and take, we are passing order by as well. With all these changes in place, let's run our project. There we go. On the initial page load, data is sorted by employee ID column in ascending order. Let's click on the ID column again. Notice now the data is sorted in descending order. Let's also test if multi-column sorting works as expected. So first, the data is sorted by ID column in descending order. Next, I want the data to be sorted by first name column in ascending order. So I hold down the control key and then click on the first name column. Notice multi-column sorting is not working as expected. We want the data to be sorted first by employee ID column in descending order. But if you look at these ID values, they are not in descending order. So let's understand what's going on. First, let's close the browser and place a breakpoint in read async method and run our project in debug mode. Notice on the initial page load, data is sorted by employee ID column in ascending order. We want to further sort this data by first name column. So hold the control key down and then click on the first name column. Our breakpoint is hit. Let me place another breakpoint here and then continue the execution. Remember, we want the data to be first sorted by employee ID column and then first name column. But notice when I hover the mouse over this order by string, the order here is not correct. First, we have first name column and then employee ID column. To correct this order, all we need to do is reverse the elements in this sort list. So let's stop debugging. On the sort list variable, let's call reverse method. Run our project again and test. Hold the control key down and then click on the first name column. Notice first the data is sorted by employee ID column in ascending order and then by first name column in ascending order. That's it in this video. Thank you for listening.